review event in WCW history, Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach.
And a new member of the Dungeon of Doom.
Plus, you'll see Stunning Steve and Colonel Parker in action.
And the Colonel has a new member of the Stud Stable, if you can call him that.
And in our main event, it's Diamond Dallas against Dave Sullivan. It's all next.
Hi, fans, and welcome to Worldwide once again, along with the Brain. I am Tony Schiavone, and what a weekend it was at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach. Yes, Hulk Hogan is still the heavyweight champion of the world, but that's not the talk right now. The talk is about Big Van Vader wanting both Ric Flair and Arn Anderson in the ring. He wants to settle the score against these two men who he thought were his friends.
Well, it goes to show you, you can be hit in the head too much. You can go off the edge, you can be nuts. There's no reason, I would think, that Vader would want to get in the ring with the 11 times heavyweight champion Ric Flair and the enforcer Arn Anderson. I hope your insurance is paid up, Vader. I think you're making a big mistake.
Fans, we have a tremendous, a great main event this week here on Worldwide. As you heard, it is Diamond Dallas against Dave Sullivan in a return from Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach. But speaking of Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach, it happened last Sunday from Southern California. We want to show you some of the action that took place and take a look at what happened at the end of the program concerning Vader, Arn Anderson, and the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
The largest crowd ever to witness a WCW event in the United States was on hand at Huntington Beach, California for Slim Jim's Bash at the Beach. Over 100,000 people enjoyed a great time in the sun, witnessing one of the best ever WCW pay-per-view events. In the main event pregame show, as Hulk Hogan was being presented a motorcycle by Orange County Harley Davidson, there was another giant sighting, but this time it was right in front of Hogan.
That shirt.
Remember this?
My Lord!
What is this? Jimmy! I know this shirt. This is Andre's.
Sting retained the U.S. title against Ming, despite an enormous dropkick to the face earlier in the match. After the match, Ming was seeking revenge when Road Warrior Hawk stepped in to help the champ away from the ring area. Renegade held on to the World TV title by a slim margin over Paul Orndorff. Replays clearly show that Orndorff's right shoulder was up before the three count. Orndorff has demanded a rematch from WCW officials. In the match of the night, Vader, straight from his roadkill tour, pushed world champion Hulk Hogan to his limits. Members of the Dungeon of Doom attempted to enter the cage, but were stopped by NBA star Dennis Rodman, who accompanied the Hulkster to the ring. Hogan survived the match and held on to the WCW championship. After the match, an angry Ric Flair and Arn Anderson confronted Vader about the survival of Hulkamania. Big Van Vader had enough and attacked both men. He then demanded a match against Flair and Arn Anderson. It was a wild ending to a memorable day at the beach.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Nuremberg, Germany, weighing 221 pounds, Germany's youngest pro wrestler, Das Wunderkind, Alex Reich.
Not only Germany's youngest pro wrestler, Brain, but also one of the most exciting men in WCW right now.
I found out the guy's 48 years old. And he's from Newark, New Jersey.
Do you listen to yourself sometime? Do you go back and take tapes of our programs and listen to yourself?
I don't care if he's the youngest star here at WCW or if he's from Germany or he's a wonder kid.
You're right on all counts. Back to Gary Gapetta.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Baltimore, Maryland, Jimmy Rogers.
The square off against Jim Rogers in our opening bout here on WCW Worldwide. Well, we are going to have some sterling information concerning Vader, concerning Ric Flair, and concerning Arn Anderson when Mean Gene joins us for our Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions update.
Well, it seems to me, Schiavone, that a lot of people are making a lot of wrong career decisions in their life.
And also, fans, we'll be talking a little bit more about another giant sighting and that shirt that Hogan says was Andre's.
Well, you know, I don't want to comment on this until I've done all my investigative reporting. I want to find out for sure what's really going down here. If it's what I think it is, it's going to be the shock of the 90s.
It really is. Jimmy Rogers certainly outweighs Alex Wright here, but Alex Wright with a tremendous amount of quickness. And Rogers wants to stall time. He wants to make sure the pace is slow.
You know, I remember him when he was a little boy.
Who?
I mean the Wonderkin, Alex Wright here. That's what I mean.
No, no, who are you talking about?
I meant the Wonderkin, Alex
you
Wright.
You meant somebody else.
No, I remember him when he started a couple years ago. I read the newspapers from Nuremberg on him.
I thought you said he was 48 years old from Newark.
Well, I just listened to myself, and you're right. It didn't make any sense. I'm sorry I said that. Disregard everything I've said.
Oh, boy.
Strike that.
Yeah, okay. No comment, right? Snapmare takeover, and Alex Wright with a front face lock. The youngster who has such a sensation, and he and Marcus Bagwell not too long ago, a very successful tag team, had a shot of becoming the world tag. Whoop, rolled him up. Becoming the world tag team champs. But Alex would rather compete in singles competition. Deep arm drag takedown.
No, I think he'd rather dance. I think he'd rather love to make the ladies happy. He's not that great a dancer. He's got two left feet, and they're on the same foot.
Two left feet on the same foot?
You've noticed that too,
no. I have not. From the neutral position now, this is where Rogers wants to be. Close proximity to his opponent, using his bulk, using his power to muscle the man to a corner. So far, good strategy. Let's see what happens. Nope, the quickness again of Alex Wright. Uppercut one more time.
Yeah, he was a little slow with that punch.
Running Alex into the corner. Look at that spring in the legs. Japanese arm drag takedown. Another one that time. And Alex Wright, the youngster, looks in tip-top shape. Fans, as we said, we will have information concerning the Clash of the Champions brought to you by Slim Jims. It'll be coming up on the 6th of August, a Sunday night. Gene will have more on it coming up in the update.
You know, I said this a while back, that Ric Flair, something has happened to him. He's not the Ric Flair I knew when he started his career, and he wasn't the Ric Flair I've known working his way up through all those championships. Something is working on his mind, and Hogan's at the bottom of it, I'm telling you.
Alex Wright!
To the Spoon European, Alex Wright!
With a big cross body block, while the brain was babbling there, with a big win here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Go ahead there, babbler. Not you, not the youngster. Talk about the brain. Go ahead, brain.
Wow, what a lucky kid. Well, anyway, let's get a shot of the Wonderkin here. Let's see what he's all about. His opponent reverses it, but he's smart enough to hit that top rope. Dangerous move comes out of it. Hits his opponent with that Japanese arm drag. Right across the chest. Once again, I hate to say it, there's your winner, Das Wunderpunk, Alex Wright.
Still to come in the telecast, the Taskmaster, a look at the new find for Colonel Rob Parker and an update for the Clash of the Champions right now. Let's go to this.
All right, fans, I've got Jimmy Hart with me. He's standing by. We're going to be talking with World Television Champ, the Renegade, as I remind you, Clash of Champions, Sunday, August the 6th. Check your local listing for time and station. It's all going to unfold in front of a national television audience. Jimmy Hart, before I talk about the Renegade and his upcoming title defense against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, I want to talk a little bit about you, my friend. Number one, that's a very snappy tie. And that suit, my word, you don't get something like that off the rack.
You don't mean, Gene, Jimmy Hart, the mouth of the South. I am all dressed up, and I've definitely got me some place to go. The man, the Renegade, that is, because we're heading for the Clash of the Champions, baby. You know, at the Bash of the Beach, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, I guess you could say we won the match, but did we win the war?
Well, that's a very good question. Hey, speaking of the Renegade, World Television Champ, in a return against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, I'll talk to you about Mr. Blackwell a little bit later on. But let's talk about the credentials of one Paul Orndorff. I think he proved conclusively that he was deserving of another chance. And Jimmy Hart, I don't know if you've opened up your arms, but you've got it, like it or not.
Well, you better believe it. You know, Mr. Wonderful, we knew he wasn't going to be a pushover. This guy's a living legend. I guess maybe in his own mind, but maybe it's in my mind. But we've got a big surprise for him, right, Renegade?
What about it, Renegade?
Mr. Wonderful, Jimmy Hart has programmed me to terminate on sight. Get ready!
Well, you've got this man psychologically honed for this title defense. And, of course, at the Clash of Champions in Daytona Beach, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff is going to be in the same frame of mind.
Well, just like I said before, the Huckster's the world champion, the WCW world champion. I'm all set. I feel like somebody's sitting on my tongue. Renegade's going to be ready for you, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
All right, Renegade World Television champ to defend against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff in a return at the Clash of the Champions on Sunday, August the 6th. Don't miss it.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Slim Jim. When you need a little excitement, snap into a beefy, spicy Slim Jim.
Back on Worldwide, as you know, there's a new warrior in the Dungeon of Doom. His name is Zodiac. He appeared at Slim Jim's Bash of the Beach. Here's a look at how Zodiac came to be in the Dungeon of Doom and a promise of yet a new warrior. Take a look.
Taskmaster, my son, I give to you a warrior that knows neither pain nor pleasure, has walked in darkness, has walked in light. I give you a warrior that will be the biggest key of all, because, Master, he is the brother of likeness himself, the man from the Zodiac.
Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you. You can be the one that has betrayed darkness, that has betrayed light. Oh, thank you. Yes.
No.
No.
Yes.
No.
No.
Thank
yes.
You, Father.
Yes. No. Yes.
Father, I know it's etched in stone, but tell me, who is the great warrior that will come? Is it Kamala?
Taskmaster! Kamala is a great warrior, but I have other plans for Kamala. Back in the darkness, Kamala!
Back in the darkness!
Father, will it be the Zodiac that will be my warrior?
Yes! No! He is too valuable of a warrior!
Oh,
because, Taskmaster, this is the brother of goodness himself! Go back into the land of Ying Yang!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
No!
Yes!
Yes!
Father, I think I know the answer! Hulk Hogan is only a man, and you're gonna say a man-eater! Shark attack! Shark attack!
The shark is already surfing the largest tsunami of all. He is on a tidal wave, chasing the millions and millions of the maniacs, biting and chewing his way to the immortal Hulk Hogan. Keep surfing! Keep surfing the tidal wave, shark!
Be patient, my son. Be patient! We will be coming.
Well, I tell you, the Dungeon of Doom and a promise of someone yet to come, Brain, and who could that be?
You got me on this one. Lift the rock and take a look.
Well, if you lift the rock right now, you're going to take a look at Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan. Oh, he is dangerous.
Imagine the thoughts that go through his mind in an average day, or after the sun goes down.
Taskmaster will face Mike Thor in this one-on-one match here on WCW Worldwide. Good to have you with us wherever you are. Mike Thor has the the unenviable task of meeting Taskmaster. And as customary, he prompts the bell with the attack on his opponent.
Well, he's just one tough man.
Head first. Thor tried to block it that time, but I don't think he had a chance. And Taskmaster clotheslines him on the floor.
Wow. And this man he keeps calling father. He keeps talking of this power. Probably the head of the Dungeon of Doom. Where is he from? What is he?
Well, those are good questions. Those are questions I have no answer for.
And a new member of the Dungeon. How many are there now?
Well, there's Kamala, as you saw.
One.
There's Shark.
Two.
There's Zodiac.
Three.
There's Taskmaster.
Four.
Vader didn't stay there long, so you can't really consider him one.
No, and a new one's coming now.
A new one is coming.
Which will make it five.
All with the want and the purpose to destroy Hulkamania. That is their purpose. That is why Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, dresses in red and yellow instead of yellow and red. The opposite colors of Hulk Hogan.
Well, he does a lot of things opposite most normal people do, but he gets the job done.
He is effective, there's no question.
One tough individual.
But when it comes to the Dungeon of Doom, as you probably know, and as we certainly feel here in WCW, this goes beyond wrestling. This is men together with a purpose. These men are together with a purpose. They are here to destroy a national hero. The double stomp, he destroys Mike Thor.
He's like in a trance half the time. Like he hypnotizes himself. Like he goes to another dimension. Like that one step beyond. He's scary.
Is he staring over? Oh, wait a minute. Kamala comes out of the dressing room area, another member of this Dungeon of Doom, and he is assaulting Thor for no reason.
Well, you don't know. Maybe Thor did something to him earlier.
Oh, get me. You believe that?
Well, I don't know. I believe a man is innocent until proven guilty.
Guilty.
I'm not the kind of a person that judges somebody
I am.
Like that.
Call me Judge Dredd. He's guilty. How does that sound?
Listen to Kamala. He sounds like he's suffering inside.
Would you be suffering with the Taskmaster on your back?
I don't know about this Dungeon of Doom. They're a bunch of scary people, Shimani. And there's the Taskmaster. He's tying his man up. And look at the velocity when he hits this man here. Moves the ring. Hogan, if they're looking for you, you better start hiding. I wouldn't want the Dungeon of Doom looking for me.
The winner, Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan, and then, of course, the attack by the Ugandan warrior Kamala. Coming up next, a look at the Slim Jims Clash of the Champions coming in August.
Once upon a time, there was a beautiful young girl who was somewhat accident-prone.
New York, as seen on Channel 2 News.
Hi again, everybody. I'm Gene Okerlund, reminding you this report is brought to you by Slim Jim. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. What a totally chaotic afternoon and evening last Sunday out in Southern California. Bash at the Beach may well be history at World Championship Wrestling, but we're going to be feeling reverberations for a long time to come. We're going to get away from that California fault line and head back to the great sunshine state of Florida for Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions. Sunday, August the 6th at 7 o'clock, live in front of a national television audience. Check your local listing for time and station. Now, forget cogent thinking. Egos cannibalized each other last weekend, and as a result, one man, Big Van Vader, challenged two men, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, in a handicap match. This particular match put together during the heat of the battle, these men are not going to have an opportunity, from what I've been told, to rethink their decisions. And also, at Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions, in a huge return match, World Television champ The Renegade defends one more time against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Of course, Jimmy Hart will be in the Renegade's corner. It's in prime time on national TV again. Check your local listing for time and station. It's going to be live from Daytona Beach, Florida, and that's 2 weeks from this Sunday, August the 6th. It's Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions. Now, for you Hotline fans, what major wrestling superstar is rumored to be getting his walking papers?
The interesting part of his getting the pink slip, he doesn't even know it. I'm going to be breaking that story and others all day this Saturday during my exclusive hotline report. Give me a call, 1-900-909-9900. There is not a more comprehensive pipeline to professional wrestling than the WCW hotline. Call now.
I want you inside here with me now.
Meet the future's most dangerous killers. One's digital.
Somehow Sid got himself out of the computer.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
The other's the law.
Where's my gun?
Come on. Doesn't mean we can't be friends.
He's interactive.
Hey, Parker!
He only enjoys playing against his favorite opponent.
This one's for you!
And that's me.
Virtuosity.
Game over.
Rated R. Starts Friday, August 4th at theaters everywhere.
Just for me.
They've been trying for hours to help you find what to wear, but they're really just wearing you out.
Oh, boy.
Just
slip
me I love this look. It's fantastic. Ooh. It's fantastic.
You know what? I'm going to try these on.
When you take a timeout, take a Twix with chewy caramel twice, milk chocolate twice, and that great cookie crunch twice. So take a timeout times two.
Your dad's got one just like it.
Timeout for Twix.
That's snappy.
The DA, out for higher office.
Can't you do anything without reporters?
I sure can, Reggie. Just as soon as you say yes.
The judge, out for justice.
The rich are different from you and me.
The witness, out of luck.
A man was killed here last night. You could be next.
The family lawyer, out of her league.
If I wind up dead, you're going to have a lot of explaining to do to Roy Foldrick.
A powerful new series with JoBeth Williams, John Hurd, and Ossie Davis. John Grisham's The Client, coming this fall.
Summer's come too soon again. Windows steam, streets sizzle, sidewalks hiss. I feel my body's water wet and insistent, and I surrender to the heat whose passion knows no mercy. Don't sweat another summer. Check your This Week at Nobody Beats the Wiz Circular for cool values on air conditioners at prices guaranteed to take the heat off. Frost kisses my window with gentle, chill lips, and I dream of summer.
From Walt Disney Pictures.
Who's going to lead this delightful little operation?
I am.
Five of America's finest have just been recruited to deliver...
You cannot put an elephant on an airplane.
One of nature's biggest...
Animal tranquilizers.
How are we supposed to get her to swallow one of these?
She's not supposed to swallow it.
Walt Disney Pictures presents... Operation Dumbo Drop, rated PG. Starts Friday, July 28th at a theater near you.
I'm Neil Padron, president. Transform your yard into a showplace with Tetra's Garden Pond Kit.
With Tetra Pond's flexible liners, you can create a free-form Tetra Pond almost anywhere, in-ground, above-ground, even indoors. And Tetra Ponds are guaranteed to last.
Tetra Pond products for beautiful water gardens, available at Petland Discounts.
Petland Discounts for the best care of pet can get.
All right, we're back on Worldwide, and I tell you, Brain... It's amazing, but Vader has his match signed, a handicap match that we know he's very successful in. But this time, the two-on-one is going to be that Ric Flair and Arn Anderson will be with him, against him, in the ring, in a two-on-one. Never seen anything like this.
Somebody's going to get hurt. Somebody's going to get hurt bad.
It's going to be at Slim Jim's Clash of the Champions, Sunday, August 6th. Live from Daytona Beach, Florida. And be sure to check your local listings for that. In addition, as you see Mike Davis, the opponent for Stunning Steve in this one-on-one matchup, we will have, Brain, we will have a return match for the World Television title. Paul Orndorff against the champ, Renegade.
Well, Orndorff should get a return match. Renegade's, you saw it as well as the world saw it. He did not pin Orndorff. He got his shoulder up. What's fair is fair.
In addition, as you know, we have coming up on the 4th of August, our next WCW pay-per-view is called Collision in Korea. Over 300,000 fans, where WCW Unprecedented, led by Eric Bischoff and Muhammad Ali and the USA contingent, went over to North Korea and kind of broke the ice, set the standard for world politics.
Well, I did a lot of negotiation, too, on the red phone.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Did you talk to the police commissioner, Batman?
No, I didn't talk to him. I talked to Mr. Woe.
Mr. Woe?
Yes.
You did not?
Yeah.
Mr. What did Mr. Woe have to say?
I can't divulge that. That's top secret.
You can't speak Korean, can you?
Oh, I can speak Korean fluently.
You can?
Yes.
Say something in Korean.
Kimchi.
Say something else.
Kim.
Over the top, Mike Davis. And Stunning Steve throws him out to the floor. Stunning Steve attacking Mike Davis. Want to remind the fans, the latest edition of, whoa, big chop there again, of WCW Magazine is available at newsstands everywhere with the Nasty Boys on the cover and great reading on the inside. Be sure to get your copy, fans.
And when you line the bottom of the birdcage, turn the cover over so it doesn't scare Tweety.
Colonel Parker kicking away on Mike Davis.
Well, the Colonel's going to do anything he can to win. He's a money man. He's the greatest promoter this sport has ever had. He negotiates some big deals for a lot of people. Auto racing, music, wrestling, anything he touches turns to gold. He's a big, big man in this sport.
Stunning Steve gets caught in the gut that time, and Mike Davis with a right hand, and now Davis getting a flurry going here. The young man with a tremendous amount of power mistimed that one, didn't he?
By about 4 or 5 seconds. I don't think it's going to be long here for Mr. Davis.
You think Vader can defeat both Flair and Arn Anderson?
Well, you know, he's two men. It's hard to tell. I don't know who to put your money on here. I hope Flair didn't make a mistake in Arn, but they know what they're doing. I hope Vader didn't let emotions take over. You don't know. But there was never a lot of love lost between Flair and Vader anyway.
No.
The only reason they worked together is for one mission. That was to get Hogan.
And when that broke down, Flair snapped.
Well, they've never liked each other. And you know Flair. He wants Hogan out of here. This is his house. This is his home. He doesn't want Hulk Hogan here. Not carrying his title.
Yeah, I know Flair. Unless you can do something for him, unless you can serve a purpose for Ric Flair, or you're a beautiful female, he has no use for you.
Well, everybody has a niche in life. It makes sense to me.
Oh, it does. You say Flair has a niche in life?
Well, Flair is a man that needs services. He needs people to chauffeur him around, carry his luggage, you know, show him the proper wine list, you know. I mean, he needs a table right up front. He doesn't have to stand in line. He's not that kind of a guy.
He's an egomaniac, is what. And you can identify with that.
Well, it works for us. It works.
Yep, I'm sure it does. And now Stunning Steve picks up. Oh, face first goes Mike Davis.
When you go to a restaurant, you leave your name to make a reservation?
My name?
Yes.
Yes.
Restaurants call Flair and myself to see if we're available to eat there that night. A little different.
Stunning Steve puts away Mike Davis. And the wins continue for Stunning Steve here in WCW. He's your winner, and we're going to take a look one more time at the win by Stunning Steve.
Well, he's a very knowledgeable athlete. Good athlete. Always in tip-top condition. And he knows what he's doing in that ring. He thinks about 3 or 4 moves ahead. He's got this ham and egg right where he wants them, hung out to dry. It's only a matter of time here. Slaps him in a good suplex, but changes his mind in midstream, face first to the mat. Another win for the Stunning One, Stunning Steve Austin.
Stunning Steve is your winner here on WCW Worldwide. Colonel Parker with him, and coming up next, the main event, plus Colonel Parker's new man is coming from Japan.
Next up here at World Championship Wrestling, the Clash of the Champions on Sunday, August the 6th. It's going to be seen in front of a national television audience. Check your local listing for time and station. I must say, and I want to compliment WCW officials in putting this fantastic card together. However, on the part of some of the superstars, I've got to question their sanity. Can you believe this? A handicap match. One man against two. But that one man is none other than my guest at this time. He is a former WCW champion, and he has held titles all over the world. He is Vader. The two men I'm talking about, Vader, the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson.
Nature Boy, listen up and listen good. And Arn Anderson, if you're by his side, as you always have been, you listen up. Vader time is going to roll on you, Nature Boy. You ain't the man, brother. You're just the man that knows the man, because you're looking at him. That's right. Me and Gene Okerlund, Vader time, we'll make history. It'll go down in the books at all time. Two men versus one. Flair, I trusted you. You stole something from me. I listened to you. We were going to own the world together. I trusted you, and you lied. And now you must pay for your lie.
You know, I got to bring something up, Vader. In all due respect, there are two men that you want to keep in front of you. You want to be able to see Ric Flair and Arn Anderson at all times. They will double-team you if they get the chance.
Gene, let me tell you something, brother. If I look afraid to you, you say so. If I look nervous to you, you say so. Because, you know what? I'd rather have them both in front of these eyes. Because you know Arn Anderson is going to be creeping around from the back anyhow. Fate of time, brother. Clash of the Champions.
Indeed.
It's going to come off
Clash
you.
Of the Champions big yeah. handicap match. Sunday, August the 6th. Don't...
Not out here. AMCO. AAMCO.
There's a new warrior coming to the United States, coming to World Championship Wrestling from Japan. Colonel Rob Parker is bringing this man all the way from the land of the rising sun. And here's a look at his new warrior.
From the scorching tropics of Kyushu to the freezing slopes of Mount Fuji, from the Imperial Palace of Tokyo to the dark back streets of Yokohama, the ancients spoke of a great warrior who one day would arise to reclaim the glory of the rising sun.
That's a scary looking man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, our feature confrontation, it is set for one fall.
Done by Gary Capetta?
Exactly.
Introducing first, being led to the ring by the Diamond Doll and accompanied by Max Muscle from the Jersey Shore, weighing 263 pounds, Diamond Dallas Page.
Diamond Dallas, of course, you were talking about the new man from Japan being sent over here and being part of the Colonel Parker stable.
Have mercy!
We'll be seeing more of him in the weeks to come.
So.
Here on WCW Worldwide. Well, the big mouth's here. Not only that, Diamond Dallas.
And ladies
here.
And gentlemen, his opponent in this main event contest.
I was talking about you.
He is from Daytona Beach, Florida, weighing 294 pounds, Dave Sullivan.
Who's not as bright as the rodent.
The rabbit is not a rodent. Doug Dellinger has...
Is that a microwave?
No, it's not. He wants his hands on Diamond Dallas. As you know, what happened at Bash of the Beach by Slim Jims. He's certainly...
Well, we know who's the brightest one in this match.
And who is that?
Well, just think about it. One man's got the rabbit, and Diamond's got all the carrots. So you figure it out. You have to be a rocket scientist to come up with this one. Would you let him do your taxes?
No, of course not. I don't think he's an accountant. And he was telling Diamond Dallas right there that she is my friend, talking about the Diamond Doll who we found out in that date that her name is really Kimberly.
You know, Dave Sullivan hasn't called home since he's been on the road.
He hasn't?
No, he found out there's an area code, and he had both of those seven numbers down. But now since they put an area code there, he's completely lost.
I don't believe that, Brain. You continue to say unkind things about this nice man, and Dave Sullivan is a nice man. And he shouldn't even get his hands dirty with Diamond Dallas Page. But then again, emotions sometimes. There he goes again.
Well, he's in love with a woman he can't have.
Look.
Shut up, you jerk.
Browbeating the Diamond Doll again. The corner they go.
You know, he picks on all her clothes. She hasn't got a say in anything. But she's got nice stuff, very expensive.
Corner.
Man's very possessive.
Get the corner. We know where you are at all times.
She's like being in a round room. She just can't find the corner.
He's getting mad at her again, just like he did at Slim Jim's Back to the Beach.
Is she a Shriner?
No. Look at this. Feigning a leg injury and kicking Dave in the gut.
He's a smart man.
Dave went in with fist ablaze that time. Great abduction on the arm as he pulls it back and out.
Well, he's a big, strong guy. There's no doubt about that, Dave Sullivan. And he's a young man. But he can't put it all together because he can't think.
How do you know he can't think?
Well, since the lawnmower accident that when he got run over.
What lawnmower accident? What happened?
Took the top of his head. Well, it's a long story.
Who told you, Kevin?
Yes.
And you believe a guy who paints his forehead like a bug?
You tell him that. I'm not. I'm not going to wind up hanging from his mirror.
The foot to the face of Diamond Dallas. Dave Sullivan connected, and Dallas goes to the floor.
See, I like what I see right here. The man's got some cobwebs, but he's smart enough to hit that bottom rope and roll to the floor to take a breather. Oh! This man is going to have some gold very, very soon. He's smart.
Oh, yeah?
Look how she lunged in front of him to protect her man.
She did not. He pulled the Diamond Doll in front. And Dave turned his back.
He's dumber this week than he was last week.
Right hand to the side of the head. And runs Diamond Dallas to the bottom. Yeah, he's in love with her. Yeah, he is.
He's smitten, all right.
He's what?
Smitten. Do you know how to use big words?
Into the ropes. He missed the clothesline. He didn't miss that gut shot, though. You saw for a moment there, you see him again, max muscle down to the apron. Front face lock. Oh, my goodness. Great maneuver.
Great move.
Arm takedown that time, and Diamond Dallas showing his ability as well.
You see, Charlie McCarthy here took too long. He waited too long. He signaled what he was going to do, the big dummy.
Well, I have to agree with you as far as ring savvy is concerned.
He's a big dummy. Say it.
No, I'm not going to
say he's a big dummy.
I'm not going to say he's a big dummy.
I'll give you a dollar. Say he's a big dummy.
Make it 10.
Down to a half a buck now. You should have gone with a dollar.
Into the midsection. Nevertheless, there's more ring savvy in Diamond Dallas than there is in Dave Sullivan. He's proven it here in this match. Dave has made countless mistakes, and each time Diamond Dallas gets capitalized on them. Let's go, Dave, for the fans. They love this man.
Could it be because they're as smart as him? Nah, that couldn't be it.
That may be what you think, but then again, you're not always right.
Max Muscle's a good-sized man. What's this move? What is this move now? It's a 9.
Oh, it's a 9, huh? Is that Max Muscle judging it, or is that...
I'm just reporting, Shivani. I don't make things up.
Yeah.
But he's got a good psychology here. He's keeping the big man down.
He does, I tell you. For all his arrogance, for all his dirty tricks, as you can see, there's one right there. For all the use of Max Muscle on the outside, Diamond Dallas can wrestle. And Dave needs some water or some air or something here. Dave Sullivan
needs some crackers.
Some crackers? What?
I've had some crackers and chewing an earmuff.
A knee to the gut.
Here comes Max.
Max Muscle.
Well, he's one of the salaried employees of Diamond Dallas. He does what he's told.
Shoulder block to the midsection. And up in the midsection again, Dave Sullivan. Dave Sullivan over the top. Dave Sullivan! Oh, 1, 2, he gets a sunset flip.
No,
he only got a 1 that time. Big clothesline. And Dave got out. Dave rolls him up. He's in the ropes, though.
He was lucky to pull that move off. It was nothing he thought about, believe me.
Well, that was a great counter move. I think Dave's showing a little bit of wrestling savvy here himself. It's very difficult when you have your mind on the Diamond Doll and when you have Max Muscle at ringside as well. So Dave has his work cut out for him. Oh, he stumbled. He stumbled. And oh my. Oh boy, that hurt me. Did that hurt you?
That can really hurt your shins.
And Dave taking advantage of it. Dave stumbled and fell to the ropes. And Diamond Dallas is being held up by Dave here. He's got him by the hair. Oh, yeah. Face first.
But you know, he's not going for the pin. He's not going for a submission.
No, good point, Brain.
Man's dumb.
I think Diamond Dallas may be in that category right now. Oh, he's bouncing around. To the corner he goes. Dave Sullivan inflicting more punishment on a dangling Diamond Dallas.
But he's not going for a pin or a cover.
Go to the eyes, he does. And a clothesline takes him down.
Now he goes for it.
Two.
And he's got him. No, he didn't.
Two count that time. The Diamond Doll cheering. I wonder who she's really cheering for on the outside. I can't hear her. Great suplex by Dave. One, two.
Come on. Who do you think she's cheering for? It's the guy with the 13 million.
Well, the guy with the 13 million takes the low road. Dave better stay away from out there. There's Max Muscle around there somewhere. He's on the other side, thank goodness.
Well, I'm going to give up $13 million in shiny cars and nice, beautiful clothes and nice jewelry to hang with a guy with a rabbit. Yeah, that makes sense.
An elbow, Diamond Dallas on the outside. Here we go. Watch out for Max Muscle. Max staying his distance, thank goodness, on the other side. Dave holding on to the trunks, to the tights. And it's a diamond cutter out of nowhere.
Well, he backed into that one.
One, two, three.
He got him.
Wait a minute, his foot was on the rope.
His foot went on the rope.
And Max Muscle threw it off.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Diamond Dallas Page.
Again with the use of Max Muscle.
Let me get a closer look at this. I'll be the judge of this.
Look, the Diamond Doll wants to go. She was going to go in the ring to console Dave, but she thought better of it.
I don't think so.
Will you listen to what he tells you, Tootsie, or is your hat too tight? There's your winner, Diamond Dallas Page. Wrap it up, Shimani.
You're a babbling idiot, is what you are.
Talking to me?
Yes.